You said you had some grudges. Who are your grudges against?
Well, number one, and my wife constantly reminds me to tone down. I brought that guy back from Israel, John Demjanjuk. It was my Freedom of Information Act which proved not only that he was innocent, but who Ivan really was. The case was so sensitive, members of Congress would say, Jim, I love you, but please, don't involve me. I sent my evidence to the Sixth Circuit Court in Cincinnati. They wouldn't accept it. I finally sent it over to Israel, to the Israeli Supreme Court, and they called me over there, and I went with the family. I did a live interview, satellite, with Brian Gumbel, and I said, when they put this innocent man to death, they're going to lose $15 to $20 billion every year they get from the American taxpayers. And Brian Gumbel says, what are you talking about? They only get $3 billion. And I said, Brian, that's only the foreign aid bill. Look at all the other trade compacts, economic assistance, military assistance. I'm saying this to you right now. Israel gets approximately $15 billion a year from the American taxpayers. That $15 billion is $30,000 for every man, woman, and child. And people in my district are losing their pension benefits. So I was targeted big time.
By the Israelis.
The Israeli Supreme Court looked at the evidence, could not refute it, and it came from the Justice Department, Greta, and they said, take him home. I brought him home, and he was bombarded ever since.
Home to Ohio.
Now he's in Germany fighting for his life. Now let me say this. Prosecutor Moskovitz of the OSI Office of the United States Justice Department suborned perjury with Otto Horn. The documents clearly state who Ivan the Terrible was, a man named Ivan Marchenko, not Demjanjuk, and they had to release him. And now they can't live with it. They couldn't live with Jim Trafficking, having beaten him in 1983. I was a walking symbol of defiance, and now they have this man in Germany. And if someone doesn't look into this, the American people should be ashamed of themselves. When you allow one American to be violated, you threaten the freedoms of every American. And I can't understand this, why no one in Congress is raising their voice. And the reason is very simple. And this may be you don't want to hear, I don't know. And I certainly don't want to hurt you on your show. You have one of the best. You're fair. But I believe that Israel has a powerful stranglehold on the American government. They control both members of the House and the Senate. They have us involved in wars of which we have little or no interest. Our children are coming back in body bags. Our nation is bankrupt over these wars. And if you open your mouth, you get targeted. And if they don't beat you at the poll, they'll put you in prison.
All right, two quick things. One is the Israelis released Demjanjuk back to the United States, right?
The Israeli Supreme Court, and I give them credit.
Give them credit.
I give them credit, big time.
All right, the second thing is Israel is a democracy and is our ally.
Yes,
right?
They are.
So you have no...
And they should be our ally. Okay. They are our friends over in that troubled part of the world.
So explain to me what you see as, you know, why you target or why you have a grudge against the Israelis.
The grudge is not necessarily a grudge. It's an objective assessment that no one will have the courage to speak about. They're controlling much of our foreign policy. They're influencing much of our domestic policy. Wolfowitz, as Under Secretary of Defense, manipulated President Bush number two back into Iraq. They pushed definitely to try and get Bush before he left to move into Iran. We're conducting an expansionist policy of Israel, and everybody's afraid to say it. They control much of the media, they control much of the commerce of the country, and they control powerfully both bodies of the Congress. They own the Congress.
Are you an anti-Semite?
No, I'm not. That's exactly what they're going to say, and I expect that. What I am is an American. And you see, I think America comes first, and we have a one-sided foreign policy in the Mideast, and we've alienated Arabs who have no way of fighting. So what they've done, and I predicted this on the House floor, is they would export violence to America, and they have. They have no other way to fight. I think President Obama knows this. I think he sees this. I think he wants to do something. I think his hands are tied. And I think he's dancing between the raindrops trying to figure how I can politically machinate some scenario to mitigate these problems. Greta, I'm saying this. America is in danger if America doesn't take back the government without foreign influence. interference.